Hi, good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to episode 854, part 2, for your fantastic Monday, September 26, 2022, and the last one of the month. Today we're going to be talking about learning about the miracle of salvation from Kimya Loder. K-I-M-Y-A-L-O-D-E-R. Kimya Loder, or Louder, however it's pronounced. If I'm butchering it, I'm sorry. But everything is derived from John 11, 38 through 44. So if you're excited about this one, smash the like button, and hitting the like button will help spread the video. So please, if you don't do anything else, just hit the like button. Birthdays, anniversaries, and prayer requests in the comment section below. And what do you take as the miracle of salvation? Let me know. If you don't want to let me know about what your miracle of salvation is, let me know some examples of what the miracle of salvation is that you believe it is. But subscribe if you're new, turn on notifications. Share the video and channel with your family and friends, and hitting the like button will share the video with others. It'll help the video be suggested to others that might want to watch it. And then help me reach at least the 20 subscriber mark by the first of the month, which is next weekend, which is Saturday. So if you do that for me, I greatly appreciate each and every one that does it. So let's get going. Let's get those 4 subscribers in this week, and I will forever be happy if I could just get 4 of them in 1 week. Not one here, one here, one here. Just to get get more than one subscriber at a time. I've been at this thing since May 2020. And I don't think I got my first subscriber until probably 21. Probably went all 21 without no subscribers. And I finally got somebody to subscribe. It finally went through. And then since then, I've only got up to 16. I would love somebody to help this channel grow. So all I ask. But the miracle of salvation, Kimya writes, blogger Kevin Lynn, L-Y-N-N, Kevin Lynn's life seemed to be falling apart. In a recent article, he recounted, "I actually put a gun to my head. It took for God to supernaturally step in to my room and my life. And at that moment, I really found what I know is God now. God intervened and prevented Lynn from taking his life. He filled him with conviction and gave him an overwhelming reminder of his loving presence. Instead of hiding this powerful encounter, Lynn shared his experience with the world, creating a YouTube ministry where he shares his own transformation story as well as the story of others." And that's basically what my channel is. I'm sharing the good news with God from the pages of these books. The Daily Bread, the Days of Praise, and the Turning Point book from Dr. David Jeremiah. But I also learn something when I do these. If you don't remember. But I learn stuff. I'll learn something every now and then. I thought, oh, I didn't know that. Like, now I do. And then other times I pray somebody else gets something out of it that I don't. Sometimes it just doesn't click. But it may click with me in another lesson from something I read in another lesson. Then it may click later on. It don't click first time I read it, but then something else will remind me of that. Wait a minute, I read that one and then the other one. It's like, you remember it. But so when Jesus' follower and friend Lazarus died, many assumed that Jesus was too late John 11:32. Lazarus had been in the tomb for 4 days before Christ arrived, but he turned this moment of anguish into a miracle when he raised him from the dead, verse 38. Did I not tell you that if you believe, you will see the glory of God, in verse 40. So after Jesus raised Lazarus from death to life, he offers us new life through him. By sacrificing his life on the cross, Jesus paid the penalty for our sins and offers us forgiveness when we accept his gift of grace. We're freed from the bondage of our sins, renewed by his everlasting hope, given the opportunity to change the course of our lives. Amen? So what are some of the miraculous ways that God has turned your life around? And how might you use your testimony to bring others closer to him? Let me know your remarks about those in the comment section below. Make sure you put Q1 or Q2 to which one you're responding to, if you feel like it. It would be nice to know. But ponder those questions by saying this phrase, which should be on the bottom of the screen, so make sure your subtitles are on so you can see them. If you don't by some chance see it, check the description. And if you don't see it there, you'll have to come back later, because this is the first video of the session, of this recording session. And it may not be there. If it's not, wait a couple hours and come back. But I'm thankful that yesterday when I was editing this, the Daily Bread video, when I went into it, that somehow or another my computer had like reset or something, and when I went over the section where the subtitle thing is, had already put the whole thing under subtitles. Somehow or another it does that every now and then. But if it does that, then I can go up there and delete the entire thing. Then I go in, put the words in there, and it goes in there. But if it's not up there, sometimes I have to come back later after it's already gone up at its normal time and go in there and set it in there to make sure it goes in there. But just remember, if it's not on there, might have to come back later and see if it's there. But it'll say, Heavenly Father, sometimes I take for granted how you transformed my life. Thank you for never giving up on me. Amen. So today's Bible reading for this one is, we ended up the Song of Solomon or Song of Songs yesterday, and today we're starting on the book of Isaiah, chapters 1 and 2. And then the other part is Galatians chapter 5. So in this one you have a part of the Old Testament and then a part of the New Testament every day. So your Old Testament is Isaiah 1 and 2. Your New Testament is Galatians chapter 5. So that's all I have for today. Coming up tomorrow, in your last terrific Tuesday of the month, September 27th, 2022, episode 855, part 2, we're going to be talking about God's help for our future. From Monica LaRose, derived from Psalm 90, verses 12 through 17. So, ooh. The little phrase tomorrow is going to be a long one. So luckily when I get that one done in a little bit, then by the time I get to tonight, when I get to it to put it up for tomorrow, it'll automatically go up there. So, okay. But stay tuned for that. I'll get to that in just a few minutes, but you'll see that one tomorrow. Tomorrow after 1. So, with that said, I love you. I appreciate it. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trust in God, and He'll keep you safe. And all you say, do it 2022 and beyond. And until later, peace out, everybody. So long, farewell. Come back later after 7 for your last Monday. Your last fantastic Monday, Turning Point Devo for this month. And episode 354. And we're going to be learning about trading worry for worship. Beginning with Psalm 9, 10, and 11. And in the recommended reading, we're going to read the whole chapter of Psalm 9. Our turning point is from Alistair Begg. A-L-I-S-T-A-I-R-B-E-G-G. Begg. And then in the Bible reading, we're reading the book of Zephaniah, all three chapters. Stay tuned for that. I'll get to that in just a few minutes, but you'll see that later after 7. So with that said, God bless everyone, and I'll see you later. Goodbye.